Non, non, ça que non. evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our special performance of chamber music. This evening's performance will begin with the Beethoven's 12 variations on a theme from Handel's Judas Maccabeus oratorio. Variations for Beethoven were very special medium. He used them in his sonatas, he used them in his symphonies. He wrote separate variations just for piano, and we're very fortunate that he wrote three different sets of variations for cello and piano. This being the earliest one of them, it's in 12 variations, with really a central variation being the next to the last, which is typical style and form of creating variations, that you take the theme and go through all kinds of permutations, but next to the last variation is this long, elaborate variation, and then it concludes with a really fanciful finale, sort of towards the end. We hope you enjoy the piece.
Thank you. lots of clapping going on now. Oh, we assume that there is lots.
The second piece on the program is the monumental fifth cello sonata for cello and piano by Beethoven. Beethoven wrote five sonatas, ranging everything from his earliest period, opus 5, to his late period, opus 102. With this last sonata, it's the first time that Beethoven actually writes a slow movement for cello and piano in his sonatas. In all the previous sonatas, these are just passing thoughts. It would be an introduction of slow and then two fast movements of earlier sonata, then a very transitional in the third, same thing with the fourth. But with this particular piece, the slow movement is actually a center focus of the entire sonata and actually takes half the time to play this work is the slow movement. Also, in this particular composition, Beethoven utilizes something that he used throughout his late compositions in the late period, and that is the fugal writing. And he writes a very devilish fugue for cello and piano. This is sort of a precursor to what he's going to do. He's already tried this in opus 101 for the piano sonata, and he will eventually write this the whole finale of a fugue, and that is in his Hammerklavier, opus 106. So this is a very monumental work, three movements. The first movement is in strict sonata allegro form. Second movement is this very elaborate arioso type of slow movement, which goes attacca immediately into the allegro fugato. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. for watching our live stream this evening. I wanted to say that it's been a sheer pleasure to play with Michelle Ron, our colleague here, and our distant colleague here, Edward Zilberkant from Alaska, teaches at University of Fairbanks, Alaska. And hopefully you can see the program and see their bios, but it is a pleasure making music with you all. Thank you. And we also wanted you to know, if you can't see the program, that we do dedicate this concert to our former colleague, Dr. Maria Roditleva Vibe, and she would want me to say that properly. So we think of her often, and we won't forget her. Thank you for coming. We hope you enjoyed this piece. Edward's going to just say just a few words.
So the final piece on our program is often overlooked, Schumann's Piano Quartet. It's Opus 47, and it is always overshadowed by his earlier piece, and that is Opus 44, Piano Quintet. But both pieces were written for Clara Schumann, his wife, who's a virtuoso pianist. And one thing to note about Schumann's output is the first part of his life, or his first period, sort of, was dedicated nothing but to the piano works. Then, of course, he had close marriage to Clara, that when he was in love with her and pining for her, that it was sort of called years of songs. There were a couple of years that he wrote nothing but songs, and during that time he wrote 120 songs for her and basically dedicated them to her. Then there was a period of his orchestral works where he was writing the symphonies, and he was really very much interested in that output. And from about 1839 to 1841, he starts exploring the chamber music, and this is where he writes the violin sonatas, and this is where he writes the string quartets and many other pieces, and these two pieces are in there. So the Schumann Piano Quartet is an interesting piece in four movements. It has a very strange first movement, it has a scherzo for a second movement, and then an incredibly gorgeous third movement, in which you will notice we will have to pause just for a little brief while the cello tunes the low C strings on the cello to a B flat, so he has to do a scordatura right before the beginning of the movement and then change back for the fourth movement. So this is something very interesting that Schumann does in this particular piece. And then for the last movement, he basically flexes his contrapuntal muscles, sort of an homage of Bach, whom he and Clara enjoyed reading the Bach Bill and Fugues almost on a daily evening basis when they got together and sort of read through all the preludes and fugues. The whole last movement is a miraculous fugue on a subject right at the end of the third movement that you'll hear. It's a wonderful piece, often overlooked, and it's a pleasure for us to play it. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
trouble for one note, but what a glorious note it was, right?
Thank you.